didn't come forward because I didn't want to face it. I couldn't bear the thought of telling people. I didn't think anyone would believe me anyway. I mean, how can a grown man get? Why didn't you fight him off? You must have wanted it. You must have been asking for it. Nobody wants it. Nobody asks for that. I just wish I'd come forward sooner. I could have stopped Nancy from getting attacked. And I'll never forgive myself for that.
Sorry,
is that
Darren, it was a one-off, I didn't mean anything.
Yeah?
Hey, pack it, Darren.
Do it.
Hey.
Hiya, it's Steve. Can't get to the phone right now. Leave us a message.
Steve, it's me. Where are you? I need you. Look, it's been a nightmare here. Everything is going wrong. Please just call me.
What are you doing here?
Well, it's pretty obvious what you're doing here. So how much have you had, Steve?
Right, don't start. I'm not in the mood.
Empty pockets.
Oh, just go home, Sinead.
No, if you've got nothing to hide. Empty your pockets. What? Come on.
I said come on. Sorry. Hiya. How did it go?
Not great.
Have you spoke to Nancy yet? You should speak to her because she's your mate.
I thought you were going to meet me outside the court.
We're shut.
We just want a couple of drinks.
We'll try the dog.
It's not a good idea at the moment.
It's fine. I'll call you later, yeah?
When are you going to get some help?
Calm down. It's not even that big of a deal anymore.
Well, I'm not going to go home with you, Rick.
I give him another 10 minutes before he realises she's around the bend.
I know what you're trying to do, Steve. Anything to change subject.
I don't need another lecture, right?
You're a cokehead. But you need help. I'm sick of telling you.
I'm sick of hearing it.
Then do something about it. If you don't get a grip, you are going to lose your kids again. I mean, what's it going to take, eh?
Well, maybe my kids are better off without me.
There we are. You love a good bit of self-pity, don't you?
What is it that you want of me, Sinead?
I want you to sort your life out.
How do I do that? Right, I have let John Paul down. I owe loads of people money. My life is a mess.
Great. Now you can admit it. Let's get you to see a doctor.
I don't need a doctor because there's nothing wrong with me. Right, I was going through a little bit of a bad patch, but I am all right now.
A bottle of wine, please. Still got it.
Were you going to wish you hadn't?
Mm-hmm.
Well, she's a bit obsessive, I'll give you that.
Obsessive? She's got a screw loose.
Well, I've heard a few things.
I heard things like she breastfed somebody else's kid.
She asked you to go back to hers. You like it because she's probably going to lock you in the cellar.
Yep.
You're like a couple of old women, ain't got nothing better to do.
Fair enough, but just don't say that we didn't warn you.
You must have a death wish.
Yeah, we all make bad life choices, don't we?
Oh, what is wrong with you today?
Nothing.
You've been drinking like a fish since you got in here. Look, whatever it is, you cannot be messing up as badly as me.
I've been seeing a married man.
Joking, eh? Come on, tell me, who is it? Do I know him?
Just a fella that I met in here. Right, it wasn't long after Katie, and I needed someone, and he was kind, but it was a big mistake, and it's over now, so...
I thought it was me that you only had a thing for.
You stop bringing up that night.
No, come on, Sinead. If it's not gay men, it's married men. You can't half-pick them.
Look, you've got a good thing with John Paul. Don't blow it.
I know. That's what I'm worried about. You ever tell him I don't want him to run a mile. I don't want to lose him.
Sounds very romantic.
You've got to get help. I'm wasting my time, aren't I? Do you know, you're really good at feeling sorry for yourself, but when it comes to dealing with stuff... All right, fine, ignore me. Right, you lose John Paul, your kids, me. I don't know why I bother.
All right, fine. I've got a problem.
As long as you admit it, you can get through it. Hey. Right. What can we do? Why don't I make you some of my famous cheese on toast? Come on.
You know, the Greeks thought that love was one soul and two people.
You said it'd only be 10 minutes, he's still here.
And I'm not going to stop till I get what I want. Have you had enough?
I'm beginning to feel that way, yeah.
Okay, well, why don't we take this back to my place? I've got the flat to myself.
I've got a bit of headache.
Well, I'm sure I can make you feel better.
I've got to get up early in the morning. I've got to take Jason to school.
But he's 18. Are you giving me the brush off?
Listen, I've been out with girls like you before and it never ends well. I mean, it's nothing personal.
How can that not be personal?
I'll call you. All right, take care.
Seriously, what is your problem? I was only feeling sorry for you.
I'm the one that should be asking you that. I'm sorry about what happened in court. I hope I haven't made things worse for you.
It's fine. I wish I'd come forward sooner.
It's okay.
If I'd have reported it, then you wouldn't have had to go to court. And you wouldn't have been...
It's not your fault, John Paul.
If you need somewhere to stay...
It's all right, John Paul. Nancy's got a home here.
Thanks, Jack.
I'm proud of you, Steve.
Yeah. Because I'm a great role model for my kids, aren't I?
I'm serious. I know it's day by day and all that, but you're taking a big step today.
I know. And thank you. Listen, whatever happens in court, me and you are going to be okay, aren't we?
Of course we are. Let's not talk about the trial, eh?
Yeah, but how can we not? It's your brother and it's my boyfriend.
I best make a move.
Do you think Finn's guilty? Come on, Sinead, I've seen you around John Paul. You can't even look at him. And I get it, it's your brother, it's difficult.
Yeah, I think he's guilty.
Right. And you're just going to let him get away with it? You need to go to the police.
I don't like it any more than you do, right? But I can't do that to Diane.
Why not? Right, her son's a rapist and she's trying to defend him.
She's his mother, what do you expect? Right, I'd be the same. I'd like to protect my son.
What?
I didn't mean lie.
Yeah, you did. You just... I just thought Diane got it wrong, but she knew that Finn wasn't at home, didn't she?
No.
Yeah, she did. And she lied to the police and she gave Finn a false alibi, didn't she?
Forget your exams and all that. You want to know what I learned at school? If you don't stand up for yourself, well, then you're going to be a victim all your life. The minute that you let people think you're a soft touch, but then you're finished. It's over. So if someone gives you a hard time, but then you sort them out, nobody thinks I'm a soft touch anymore.